friends, we welcome Sri Suresh Bhai Kotak, the veteran, the Bhishma Pitama of cotton textile industry in India and a well-known thought leader across the globe. Welcome Sri Suresh Bhai, the group chairman of Kotak Group of Companies and everything in cotton that Suresh Bhai says has value, and his views, his experience, his logical mind, his knowledge compiled together, I mean, can be more than an encyclopedia for the textile industry. Welcome, Suresh Bhai.
Thank you, Manish Bhai. Well, we are meeting after Diwali for a new year.
Right.
Well, what would you like to know from me?
Sir, the industry would like to know a lot from you. How was 2017, according to you, for the cotton and textile industry?
I think it was a reasonably good year. Okay. Textile industry has definitely started improving. There is a lot to be done and a lot to be understood. Textile industry in India, in my opinion, can progress very well. We may have to change some of our strategies,
okay,
and some of our priorities. One thing is sure, that plastic is acknowledged as destructive or harmful to the environment due to its non-biodegradability.
Right.
This gives a chance to cotton, because polyester is also a kind of plastic family. So, I feel that new era for cotton will begin or should begin has already begun. If we see the statistics, the consumption of cotton has been increasing in the last 2-3 years. At international level, the IPAC statistics are clear that consumption of cotton is increasing in a composition of fiber composition, a little.
Right.
Though it is little, I personally feel that in days to come, this trend can become profound, the acceleration of cotton consumption, I expect. But it will be slow process. Now, as I understand, the leading polyester manufacturers of the world have changed their policy from producing more to recycle, reuse. So the policy on polyester itself seems to be changing world over, because people have realized that in order to be environment friendly, the only way out is recycle and reuse. So this particular concept development has been all around the world. I was recently in Paris, and when I discussed with people, I feel that slowly the mindset has started changing. So this will affect cotton. So long-term outlook for cotton, I feel, will be good. Is good, but will be quite good.
Okay. Is good and will remain to be good.
Now the statistical position of cotton this year, in India in particular,
right,
is likely to remain slightly tight.
Okay.
Because of the rain god has not favored us fully, and there is a deficiency and inadequacy of rain.
Right.
And still we are much rain dependent nation. Especially cotton is also very dependent in India. So either we take our stance on cotton to more and more of drip irrigation and other technologies, go for better rotor harnessing. A lot of things need to be done. If a country like Australia can produce, despite water shortage, quite a lot of things with good amount of high productivity much more, about more than 3 times or 4 times than India.
Yeah, 400%.
Yeah. So our only solution is increasing productivity and improve processes and quality. We need to improve our processes and quality very much. We have to weed out order duration. Order duration, in my opinion, is a great terminus.
Okay.
Then even contact duration. Because order duration cannot be removed in global. Contamination still can be removed in the room, but order duration is a clear waste. As a matter of fact, short fibers, we have to realize, is a complete waste. Just like a stretch is a waste, this is a waste and disadvantage to the mill. So that much cotton becomes costly because of this mixture. Order duration actually is nothing else but fraudulent packing of cotton. Any kind of fraudulent packing is really a disaster. And single most thing, priority most thing is to be done is remove order duration. This will give itself a good effect. Now, for that, we must have a policy. One seed, one village. That is a very important thing. This trade must come. Even the ginning factories, where they should be allowed only to confine their ginning on one quality. So if we establish uniformity of quality, Indian cotton will fetch more than 7-8%, 7-8 cents in price. The farmers will benefit, the productivity will improve. So we have to improve the input in terms of better seeds, better processing, better what, better management, drip irrigation, irrigation should take place,
and quality
maintenance. So if we do this, we will get good return, and the solution of India is in that.
Suresh bhai has highlighted so many important points in one answer. One is productivity. Focus on productivity is prime. We must focus on not increasing the area, but increasing the yield per area. Because Australia, in spite of the weather challenges, has 400% more yield output than India. Israel is an example that the right has set itself towards the world. Brazil, 100% rainfed country, nearly more than twice the yield output of India. So productivity is the one main thing. Second thing is quality management. And quality management comprises of two things which are hampering the Indian cotton prices. One is contamination, one is adulteration. Contamination, Suresh bhai feels, is a menace, but adulteration is a bigger menace because it is a clear waste for the spinning industry. They buy cotton and it just comes out as waste for them.
True. So they buy cotton 20%, 10%, 15% higher price.
Yeah, yeah. And just falls off as a venture, which increases the cost per kg for yarn for spinning unit, which is disastrous. So that has discounted the Indian cotton a lot.
Yes.
And to gain the premium, this has to be managed and managed on a priority level. Second thing that he said about the seeds was, one village, one seed would really help us combat this issue on a larger scale, because implementing on a very small scale is not enough. It has to be implemented on a commercial scale across the country. So one village, one seed, and then ginning factories managing the quality as per standard parameters would again fetch them a good premium. Because second question coming out of this, this year the industry is facing a huge disparity as far as spinning and ginning is concerned. Farmers don't want to sell cotton at a lower rate,
sure,
and fabric market not doing so well. So the ginning and spinning industry is squeezed between these two. So what is the way out? What is the disruption that you...
One more thing I want to add.
Okay.
I I saw recently in the Raplan area and wherever I went.
Okay.
Farmer also sows different seeds. So adulteration is very menacing.
Actually, from the farming level.
But at a farming level also. And that is why I advocate one
seed,
one village, because there has to be a purity of cotton, non-adulterated cotton. The prime necessity of cotton economy is non-adulterated cotton, because it is so disastrous that the whole country is looking on this, and we have not realized that the kind of total damage that is being incurred. It's a total damage, it's colossal.
Right. The damage created by in your presence was assessed in our Cotton Guru Cotton Conclave with the IMC. 13 March 2018, we had given figures, and it was published in the white paper also. 3,600 crores.
Yes.
360 lakh bales and 1,000 rupees per bale.
Yeah.
Is the discount that India is into 3,600
right.
crores of loss.
So what a loss to the economy.
Correct. Without even coming out in the market to sell, we have lost 3,600 crores. That is a huge setback that the industry is facing, and the disparity is arising out of that because of this mismanagement of quality. So what is the
now in textile industry, now this is the input side of cotton and how
right.
to make cotton function very effectively, very efficiently.
Right.
The other point is that on the marketing side, what I have been studying that our product basket is very small.
Okay.
India must have great product diversification. In the world, if you see the various HS code, there are 8,000 items, say for example, or more in the textile HS code. When you compare with our HS code in terms of production, we have hardly 20 to 30 items only. So our product basket is so small.
Right.
So on one side, the mills suffer because they are not able to sell what they produce.
Right.
Whereas we are losing the market, and though the fact is that America wants to abandon China to be supplying all the things, but India is not able to rise to that level in the product basket. So our product portfolio is very, very small. So in order to get the market of the world, we must change our product portfolio. If this is done, I think our textile industry can boom within 5 years.
Product basket. Suresh Bhai has highlighted is we have a very narrow and a very small product basket. If you go to a hotel or a restaurant, if you find only 5 items that they offer, how excited would we be to go to that restaurant again? And if you find 50 items in the menu, we find, okay, we have a choice here. Out of 8,000 odd items which are enlisted in the HS code, India has only 25-30 of them. Very, very small quantity for a leading nation, the largest producer of cotton, second largest consumer of cotton in the world. And we can gain both ways, like Suresh Bhai said, US needs finished goods which India can offer, and China needs raw material which India can offer. So in this
we have a fantastic opportunity.
Right.
And let me tell you, recently I came across one author. They say, opportunity is the most perishable commodity.
Okay. Opportunity is the most perishable commodity.
If you don't see it, it is not available, it is with us. But if you seize the opportunity, you get it. But it's the most perishable commodity.
I agree with you, and India needs to rise to the occasion.
And somehow or other, our policies, our red tape thinking, our way of doing business is also very slow, still tardy, still
very unprofessional.
So what happens is we are in a syndrome, a syndrome of loss of opportunity. So every day you find that despite even a better as a conducive condition, we lose the opportunity. So glaring things also we ignore, and opportunity can just not be.
Opportunity and time waste for no one, and
highly perishable one side.
Highly perishable, absolutely. And like there is a saying in Gujarati or Hindi that jab Lakshmi tilak karne aati hai, tab muh dhone nahi jaya.
Chand to karwa.
So we have to rise to the occasion. We have to.
Now today China is reporting ground. How much we are ready? Surat has 40 million meters production of cloth every day. There's a huge production done by Ichal Karanji.
Right.
Now just go and see the local economy. But if you see everything, stand alone at every point.
Yes.
The stand alone not getting into integrated. So what we need is integration at all places. In cotton production, we need integrated crop management. Not integrated pest management. We talk about IPM, but we must talk about integrated
crop management.
So this is, then we must have integrated chain, and even all in the final chain up to the whatever our Prime Minister say, up to fabric or up to fashion.
Right.
See the supply chain. Our supply chain is highly truncated, highly punctured, highly halting, and at every point there is a difficulty. So our chain itself runs through all the kinds of difficulties, which makes our deliverables very poor. We are not able to fulfill any contracts in time. Neither the size, nor the quantity, nor the variety. Then if you do not give to the buyer what he wants, how will you sell? The whole thinking in India, in textile, is selling what we produce, not marketing what buyer wants. So marketing and selling concept, which is there in the professional management theory, is here. We want to sell our goods. We don't want to market out. So this approach in textile is a killer. So this is killing our textile industry. This is killing our cotton production. So these are the inefficiencies with which our cotton and textile economy suffer. So this needs remedial measures.
Absolutely. It is a very, very deep-rooted disease. Productivity on one side, like Suresh I mentioned, second thing, efficiency. Quality management, then now coming to even time management and contract management.
Yes.
So what we need to do is think deeply within us, are we going to be successful standalone ever in this highly competitive industry?
When you talk to Australian economists on the commodity, they succeed on 2 points. Australia, they succeed on best management practices. Every year, they work out best management practices which has helped.
Okay.
The difficulties which they suffered. So every year they update their document of BMP every year to give guidance or operating guidelines to the farmer. Every year that document is a valuable document, and their scientists as well as farmers at their joint meeting work out this document. I have seen that document. I recently in my visit to Ratlam, I discussed with the KVK people. They say, we have some documents. I said, but do you update every year? Do you take with the farmers meeting that you have, why don't you create these documents? You have to have a reach out. Where is your reach out? What is your reach out? They say, no, we have never thought. I say, we would like to also, of course, I will write to government and I will talk to government. I will request government that we must have standard documents every year updated, which show what go around the country. And crop is a locational specific. So we have to study the area and we have to see that KVK does this job. So they have to come out with BMP every year with the local general as well as local data. So if we do this, I think the production, not only in cotton but all agriculture commodities, will go with lips and mouths.
Right. It's so important that making a record is not worthwhile unless you act on the record number one and unless you update that record.
Constantly capture your experience. Yes. When we go for a Kisan, I said, you had Kisan Mela. What is the summary? You talk, he talked, I talked, you talked,
yes,
gave lecture.
Yes,
what is that? What did you resolve? How do you take forward?
Yes.
What do you do? Only talk. Committee meeting, just come for tea. This way the things can't run. How do you progress? You can't.
There has to be a purpose behind
everything. There has to be a purpose, there has to be a very seriousness about the whole thing. And I have seen scientists working there. Here, Indian scientists are very intelligent. But somehow or other, their voice is very limited. And we have to give them the voice. Our Indian scientists are just brilliant. But their voice does not get effective extension services. The extension services, our ideas are very limited here. And I saw the extension services in Australia. See how much less land, how much more productivity. Why they do? They say in agriculture economics theory all around the world, I have seen that 30% of the productivity improvement depends on agronomic practices and policies. This is the dictum of various agriculture economic books that I have worked. 30% productivity can increase only out of the good practices.
30% is huge. I mean,
I'm telling you,
5% increase is such a good challenge.
And this is a theoretical base. I have seen a lot of literature.
Okay.
30% productivity can change.
Oh, wow.
But we have to be very, very, very aligned to this situation.
We have given a very loose slogan today, Suresh Bhai Kotak, farm to fashion is good. But right now the need of the hour is lab to farm. How can we bring technology to the farm so that even the smallest of farmer is benefited? This will directly benefit the whole technology.
And deliver the message to the farmer to strong connectivity with every year BMP, which runs through the experience, which runs through the concept, which runs through actual field difficulties captured and compressed. And give that dose every year, the productivity will go leaps and bounds.
Right. Farm solutions right on the farm and corrective and preventive measures clearly defined for the farm. Very good, sir. Sir, what for the industry again, what can be the just a last question. What the industry has to do right now? Do the
industry has to work on these two fronts.
Okay.
Because the cost effective cotton, quality cotton, and quantity cotton, and reasonably priced cotton can work the whole situation. And secondly, the improve the basket base, the product base has to be widened and widened, sufficiently widened. We are on very narrow and we want the progress to take place, which is not possible.
We have to be global.
Let us learn our limitation and overcome it.
Definitely. So, by slogan, Swachh Kapas.
Swachh Kapas. Swachh Kapas. Swastha Kapas. Saksham Kapas. And Satatya Paka. So, five punch sheet on cotton is the answer.
Absolutely right. And if you can just follow these five words, I think we have a very bright future for India and Indian cotton textile.
Thank you, Manish Bhai.
Thank you for being with us.